starts accusing me of being happy, that one is the which we are living in. Public exam, two of the 8th standard students, Akka University evaluation, and also all the big boss atrocities. You guys are so cool that you are so happy even amidst just all these miserable miseries. A very pleasant good morning to all the people who are seated here. In this era, we can see that there are two different kinds of things, even as the two sides of our way mission. On the one hand, we can see a quote, statistics from World Health Organization that says, one in four people suffer from mental disorder. There are more than 300 million people who survive from depression globally. There are more than 1 million people who die of committing suicide. It is also predicted that by 2020, the rate of death by committing suicide will be 1 in every 20 seconds. But don't get bothered, don't get worried. But on the other hand, you can see some quotes like, laughter is the best medicine. Smile is one of the best makeup that any girl can wear. We can find out that all these things like happiness is something that which is vital and that which is affordable. If any of you guys in this crowd just raise your hand and ask me, saying, Franklin, I'm lacking in this aspect which is called as happiness, joy, and laughter, I'm going to suggest you some four important pillars which I do personally follow in my life, which is going to raise you up in this aspect. The first important point is, help people around you. Few years back, there was a man who committed suicide from one of the longest bridges in London. During the police investigation, they found out a letter which had some interesting words in it. It goes like this, I'm going to walk right from the beginning of this bridge, even to the end of the bridge. If at least one, let me repeat, if at least one looks at me and smile, then I am going to drop my plan of committing suicide. How many of you, having entered this hall, looked at a stranger and smiled? In this digitalized and modern world, you have learned many things, but forgotten the basic and innate thing in us which is called a smile. We might have forgotten many things. We can see that helping is only giving some food or giving some money, but also sharing someone's burdens, lending a shoulder to someone who is badly in need of it, and even wiping away the tears of your dear ones is also a help. One day when you realize that you are the reason behind one smile, that's the day which says that you are living. How many of you in this crowd want to be alive? Can I see the hands raised, please? Everybody wants to be alive. Good. Then start helping people around you. The second important point is, change your negativity into positivity. 4 years back, during my 11th standard, there was an English teacher who called me and told me, Franklin, prepare well. Tomorrow you're going to read the news during the assembly. The next day, I woke up early in the morning, rushed to the newspaper shop. I touched the English newspaper called the Hindu for the first time in my life. The smell was so good, you know. And then I just opened it, took some points in it, prepared a speech, went down to the podium. I was like this behind the podium. And I gave a powerful speech. Sorry, that was my assumption. Then, during the fourth period, my English teacher called me and told me, Franklin, what did you read? We were not even able to understand even a single word of yours. On that day, I thought that my rate of speech was my negative. After which, I came and asked my Toastmaster mentor, Toastmaster Vasan. He gave me a wonderful explanation, which took some weeks for me to understand even its meaning itself. He told me, Franklin, are you going to drop the rate of speech saying that it's your negative? Or are you going to find out the negative in your negative and make it positive? Let me repeat, Franklin, are you going to drop the rate of speech saying that it's your negative? Or are you going to find out the negative in your negative and make it positive? Difficult, right? He just asked me to improve my clarity. And when I did this, my so-called negativity became my positivity. How many of you in this crowd think that you are fat? And think about a person like Manohara who's going to gym and practicing for 6 months. He's daily practicing, you know? Even my friend does it. How many of you think that you don't even have your basic requirements met? Think about a person who's eagerly waiting for his next meal. In this way, I want to say is, as long as you keep on thinking negative and negative and negative, do you know what you are doing? You are drawing a single horizontal line in a wide sheet of paper, which is your life. But when you start thinking positive, when your perspective towards life changes, do you know what you're doing? You're once again drawing a line, but this time it's not horizontally, but vertically, and thus making it positive. How many of you want to be positive? Wow, this is so sweet. Third important point is, don't hate people. In these days, when we switch on the television, a flash news flashes like this. And also a debate program which goes like this. We can see that people who start hating and arguing one another, even for silly and petty reasons. The number of divorce cases in the court is a standing living example of this point. But a gentleman once said like this. Dislike people, it's okay. Let me repeat. Dislike people, it's okay. But don't hate people. Because hate is a disease. It first destroys your enemy, and then you also. Start to love people. Start to appreciate even some small things that people do for you and for your achievement. The last important point I want to say is, believe that you are born with purpose. There was a man in U.S. on November 5th, 2003, Gary Leon Ridgway, a U.S. serial killer, was sentenced to life in prison. On that day, all the relatives of the victims, they were asked to say a word about Ridgway. They all came and they told him, you'll go to hell. You'll have the most miserable hell. You're the most wretched person I've ever seen in my lifetime. When all these people intentionally cursing him, the face of Ridgway was like a stone, emotionless. But after which there was an old man who stepped on the stage and he told the following words. Ridgway, I know that people hate you, but I'm not the one. Even as God has told me to forgive, I forgive you and you are forgiven. Even before these words could come out of that old man, a person was sitting like a psychopath, reactionless, emotionless, broke down into tears. Maybe you might think that I don't have money, I don't have knowledge, I'm useless, I'm fit for nothing, therefore I'm not born with a purpose. Maybe your purpose may be to promote peace and harmony in all the places wherever you go with a sweet smile on your face. Maybe your purpose may be to change a stony heart into a fleshy one, even as in the case of Ridgway. Trust me, you are born with a purpose. There are any number of things that come to the market every day. We pay for them, we buy them, we try them, even without knowing whether it's good or bad, but just blindly believing the advertisement and the one who's acting in the advertisement. In the beginning, when I ask you some questions like, how many of you are happy? I was able to see some hands that were not raised. I suggest you to try all these four pillars. Firstly, don't hate people. Secondly, change your negativity into positive. Thirdly, help people around you. And last but most important, believe that you are born with a purpose. When you can try all these things which cannot give you assurance, why can't we try those things which can fetch you happiness, which can make you a better human being and a better social element? Smile is one of the greatest gifts that God has given to humanity. Laughter is one of the best inventions that has been ever invented in mankind. Make use of these things like smile and laughter. Spread them. Make this world know about the power of it and make this world a better place to live in. Before I conclude my speech, let me say a small thought. Yet, when it is forced from outside, it breaks. But in the same egg, when it is forced is created within, it creates new life. Hoping for the new life, thank you.